anything. I've just unmuted everyone. I've just muted everyone, I mean. So you can just put in the chat box, so that will be active. So before I start ahead and move, just give me a minute or so that I go live on Facebook, the group. It's wonderful to see so many people on a Saturday evening. It used to be in historic times, जैसे बोलते ना पुराने जमाने में, जैसे फ्राइडे को आज के दिन पिक्चर रिलीज होती थी. सिमिलर वे पुराने जमाने में आजकल के दिन में लोग आउटिंग करते थे, पार्टी करते थे. सो दो थिंग्स ओके लाइव. यस वी आर लाइव नाउ. Just a second, I'll just need to check again. Once I'm done, I'll be starting. Great. Okay. So yes, I'm online. So guys, welcome again to today's session. If there is any problem in audio, is there anything not clear, please feel free to stop me. And the co-host kindly keep on admitting whosoever joins at whatever time till we are 100. We have slots till 100, so please go on admitting. So yes, it is a demo session. I have, as I said yesterday in my paid group also, we are doing just a little bit of testing on my part to check the viability of this, because there is a lot of marketing research data available on digital platforms, which believes that once the things improve, the digital platform is going to collapse by 95%. So that is actually a very disheartening state for some people like me. But then I don't feel bad, because some of my topics, or rather most of my topics, are actually, say, they can be done offline as well. It is not a clinical thing that you need a hands-on demo or something. So is the screen visible? Somebody can just put in the chat box. Is the screen visible clearly? Okay, thank you, Rajat. So let's start today's session of practice management. Yesterday I had one for a paid group. Today it is one for the free group. So as we were discussing with Rajat and many other colleagues yesterday, we are 256 into 5 plus another 32 odd in the sixth group, or the T group, or the temporary group as I call it. So more than almost, I calculated more than 1300 people. And even if we reach 40 to 50, it is a good percentage in that sense, maybe 4 to 5%. I go that. So all my presentations always begin with thanking the Lord Almighty, who's given me much more than what I deserve in my life. And this is my brief biodata. You all are actually aware of it. So today we are here to the free Zoom session for the free groups, all my five and the six groups on practice management. So yesterday it was on goal setting and target audience capturing. So today the topics will be broadly, it will be patient satisfaction, then the tips to improve patient satisfaction, a little bit about bargaining, then the patient satisfaction components, the ASAP funda, and creating patient experiences. So always I tell to my online or the offline audience in any way. So Dr. Arun, check kindly at your end. I hope my audio is clear to everyone. So just check out at your end. There might be a connection issue, or there might be a headphone issue. So kindly do notify me in the chat box if there is any problem. So I'll be checking the chats side by side. So I always say that at any given point of time, you have any, say, misconception, any kind of, you will say, misunderstanding, or any kind of clarification you need, please feel free to stop me there and then only. via chat message or because I have muted the audios because the people are constantly joining in, there will be disturbance. So I just muted all the audience presently. I'll be enabling it after the end of the presentation for any queries. Yes. So I have no such qualms that my rhythm would be broken, that I'll be losing my steam or anything similar. So please feel free to stop me. Feel free to ask me anything at any point of time. The presentation is approximately going to take 50 to 60 minutes from now. So let's get going. So today's topic broadly is patient satisfaction. So there is a Nobel winning psychologist named Daniel Kahneman. He actually has a study which says that people approximately have 20,000 individual moments in a waking day. Imagine the number of minutes and number of seconds and the emotions of the moments we go through. Again, as they say, each moment may be lasting a few seconds, but each of that moment is important. Sometimes to catch attention of your patient, sometimes to gather the attention, sometimes to just click with the audience, you just need a very little time. Some people can do it in a very short time, some people are not able to. And people do tend to absorb and reflect the atmosphere around them. These are the emotions, they actually do it. So the master key is always to have the magnetic ratio or the magic ratio of your team and your patients. It is a team effort. It is not an individual thing. I am not the only one working in my clinic, and I am not the only one who will actually say be responsible for everything. So Dr. Rajni, actually the only thing is that the audience will keep on joining. Either I have to close the waiting room, otherwise the yellow box keeps on appearing, and that will be an issue otherwise. We have done it in the past, that orange box you can see at the top. When somebody joins in, we actually have a box appearing. So I have to just then reschedule to this mode and then enlarge the presentation again. So either I close the waiting room. Once there are 100 people, I just request the co-host kindly close the waiting room, and then I can shift to full screen. So, and yes, the key is the magic ratio between you, your staff, your team, and your patient. It is always a teamwork. And as the team word says, together everyone achieves more. So we have to be actually in sync with this. If you believe that you are the only one and you can do all the things all by yourself in a clinic, then believe me, you are actually wrong. So satisfaction is one thing which is actually a component which cannot be exactly measured. For many community, we have read about many indices in the community and industry. We can actually measure various, quotients in a different manner. But patient satisfaction is a very, difficult component to measure in that sense. So it is not easy to measure, but yet it is a proxy indicator to the success degree of the clinic. This is the beauty of the patient satisfaction. And believe me, the sooner we realize this thing and the closer we get to the higher success in the clinic. So there is a first law of service given by Harvard professor David Master, who has actually given the satisfaction as a straightforward mathematical formula. And trust me, maths can never leave you. When I'm there, maths will always be there. And as I am a big fan of mathematics and finance, you all know. So he says S is equal to P minus E. Satisfaction is equal to perception minus expectation. Try to understand the ideology over here. The patient comes into your clinic with a certain set of expectations, maybe a referral, maybe from someone heard about it, just a hearsay, or maybe from just via your physical advertisement. He just walks in. But then once he enters, he makes, as I told you about Daniel Kahneman, he just forms an atmosphere around his mind, or creates an aura about you in his mind. And that is what we call as the expectation. And what you give to the patient via your treatment, SAB or VSAB, I always say the both words, SAB or VSAB, treatment-wise and treatment-wise. Treatment means dental treatment-wise and otherwise treatment, whatever you offer via your internal management, internal marketing. So that is going to create a perception or a score in his mind. And if that perception or the score is positive and it crosses the expectation bridge, then the resultant degree would be positive and the satisfaction would be achieved handsomely. But if not, the resultant would be dissatisfaction. So this is a straightforward formula which actually says it all. So if the patient perception meets or exceeds their expectation, then definitely correspondingly there will be a degree of satisfaction. But if it does not meet the expectations, there will be a resulting dissatisfaction. So it is all about meeting or say exceeding those expectations. So there is a Japanese Kano model also on this. So which says that unless you meet the patient's needs, the performance indicator wise or in other sense, then you will achieve satisfaction. In a similar way, the curves are there. The Kano model is just an indicator of that. So it is all about the mind game. Whatever you do, it is not always the treatment which will fetch you brownie points. It is the treatment otherwise also which you render to the patient via your behavior, via your staff, via your say little small points which you can add up actually, which create a perception in patient's mind that you actually care. Even a follow-up call can be one of them. So the expectations, as I say, it is all the mind thing. And if they are met properly, the patient, if they're not met, the patient will be dissatisfied. But if they are met, he'll be correspondingly happy and satisfied. Even though sometimes the results of the treatment may not be 100% expected by the patient, still the resultant degree of satisfaction will be there because the other angle, the other end of these things would be there. So there is a normal level of service which we have to consider, and small little factors which play a role in those patient satisfaction can be waiting time, can be scheduling, can be appointment system. These are the things which actually make a lot of difference. I'll be giving you some tips over that because I'm sharing the whole concept today on this in brief. So we have to understand that if the patient has chosen us out of the 10 guys in our area or whatever the number you are there in your area, you may be 15, you may be 5, you may be 20 in your area. But if the patient chooses you, there has to be some reason behind it. Respect that reason and try to give your best. And David Master, I mentioned about his first law. He has actually given a second law as well. So he says that it is hard to plan catch up ball. What does that mean? It means that sometimes we have to actually spend a lot of energy, time, and say resources in our clinic. The orange box will come in. The orange box will continue to appear. I have been doing presentations, and whenever the people keep on joining, it is there. Dr. Balveer, check the connection at your end. I hope a couple of you have the audio problem. So it is a halo effect created by that stages of service encounter. And if money, time, and attention is to be spent in improving, it should be done in doing the quality of service. Because that payback will occur in early stages itself. That is the beauty of this. This law, this is the second law of service. The first law of service, as I said, was S is equal to P minus E. See, in spite of giving the time, people are joining in right now. So we can't actually go about that task. So it is hard to play catch up ball in that sense. So patient satisfaction can be resultantly created by information, education. I always say the other IND. The first IND is the, say, income and expenses. The other IND is the patient education part. It is actually, again, a relevant phenomenon in that. And who can do that? They can create a differentiator between themselves. They can actually doing it. So Dr. Sabyasachi, I'll be taking up queries. Don't worry. So let me just give you a tip, a few tips to improve patient satisfaction. So just let me check the meeting controls. I'm just making it for full screen, but you'll see the orange box interrupting you at various points. Let's hope it doesn't create a problem because people will continue to join in. So let me give you a few tips to actually bullseye the magnetic ratio or the magic ratio, as I said, which is there. So the number one would be pull. Don't push the treatment options. What exactly lies in this? I normally give this example very commonly. I'll just repeat it again, because since the audience is comparatively new today. So let's suppose the patient walks into your clinic with a caries 3-6. It is an obvious case of a root canal. Yes, don't bypass the radiological norms or the any other history bypass. Let's keep those aside for a moment. It's an open and shut case of a root canal. Let's suppose. Suddenly your attention shifts to the patient's right side. 4-5, 4-6 missing. So the basic human tendency in this would be man mein laddu phoota. So that is the basic approach, the Cadbury ad, which we are all fond of. We like to actually start the treatment on 3-6 and then shift to 4-5, 4-6, because that is the human tendency, because the money or the moolah is going to come out from there only. But that is where we actually do the mistake. We have to treat the chief complaint first. And that chief complaint is to be treated via the three E's: efficaciously, efficiently, and effectively. These are the three E's I always tell to indulge in. Once you indulge in these three E's, give the proper treatment. Yes, as a parting duty, once the patient is about to leave you, it is your endeavor or duty to inform the patient about the other IND, the information and education about the missing 4-5, 4-6, as I said, and let the patient be pulled back towards you rather than you pushing the treatment plan of that. Yes, it will be a difficult task, but you can falter on two accounts, either by over pushing. The second thing, by not letting the patient know that the other work needs to be done. That is your duty. But again, you are not a car salesman. So don't push the option like that. It is just let the patient be pulled back to you for your good service or decent service account. Then engage your patients. That is always the best way. I always say, if you are bogged down in your OPD in huge numbers, you will not be able to actually give your whole attention to your patient. And once you actually actively engage your patients via your good communication skills, you will see so many conversions happening, which you might be actually lagging in. Ultimately, it is the conversion in your clinic that matters. The number of OPD, the number of consultations you do doesn't matter at all at the end of the day. The number of conversions matter. And ideal ratio, as I always say, let's see the orange box is there. So even if you admit, the orange box will be there still. So engage your patients. Luckily it's gone. Thanks. So that is the way you have to actually be aware of this thing, that your first consultation, your conversions play a role. And ideal ratio, as I say, is 7.2 out of 10 or 72 out of 100. So any 100 consultations you do, if you are converting 72 out of them, believe me, you're doing excellent. A minimum ratio acceptable is 4 to 4.5, 40 to 45 out of 100, and an average ratio 5.5 to 6.5, as we say. So nobody can have 100% conversions. So even if you try and you fail, remember that you're not doing bad either. If you are having a decent enough, a merit wise score, 70 plus or 72, then pre-frame and ask permission for every step you take. This is actually a part of consent only, of course. It is the patient's right not to be touched without any permission. Some people take consent for even a physical checkup. I mean the dental checkup itself. You don't need to do that actually. Because if the patient has walked in himself or herself, it is actually an implied consent. So you don't need to go about that task. So be short and sweet. Do not go on singing your own tunes in your clinic. Create an aura of care, not a aura of obsession. So then be persuasive, elegant, and expressive. Use stories. Rajat is very fond of telling stories in clinic. He has been guiding all of us. Even I have learned a thing or two from him in this regard. But yes, there are various ways you can actually convince your patients via your stories. The enamel can be perceived as the head of the family or the protector of the family in a similar way. And these are the various stories you can actually make to involve. The whole aim is to involve the patient. in your conversation. Nobody wants to listen to a crap. Nobody wants to. He is only concerned about getting his or her pain relieved. Then give choices or options to your patient. It is their right. The Supreme Court ruling also says it, 2008 ruling, the patient has to be given all the choices irrespective of whatever economic status he has and irrespective of whether you are offering the service or not. I'll just simplify it by an example. Let's suppose the patient is a class 4 or a sweeper kind of a patient. He has a missing tooth. He still needs to be given an option of implant. And even if you are not doing an implant, that option still needs to be given. Whether or not you are doing it or not, whether you're in your case, the crown and bridge might be your first option. So you have to understand the two things. Then the biggest tip I can say is always respect your patient's decisions happily. Patient ko aapne prepare kiya crown and bridge ke, let's suppose. Patient sara ko sunta aram se, he is smiling, he seems to be getting towards your desired or suggested treatment plan. एंड में वो बोलता है आरपीडी लगा दो. तो डोंट मेक अ कद्दू लाइक मूव. कद्दू की तरह मूव मत बनाइए, खुश रहिए. तो इवन इफ द पेशेंट इज देयर, यस वॉर्न द पेशेंट ऑफ द हार्मफुल साइड इफेक्ट्स ऑफ द प्रोसीजर. वॉर्न इट वेरी क्लियरली. एंड बिकॉज समटाइम्स पीपल विल कंप्लेन, ये आपने इतना जोर दे के नहीं मुझे बोला था. वॉट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन अ प्रोसिजिवनेस एंड लेस प्रोसिजिवनेस. बट देयर यू हैव टू ड्रॉ अ लाइन. दिस इज माई रिकमेंडेशन. If you're going ahead, it is your choice. Kindly be aware of all the side effects. ये terminology उल्टी नहीं use करनी है कि अगर कुछ हो गया तो मुझे मत कहना, मुझे blame मत करना. That is a wrong terminology to use actually. So there has to be a very careful selection of words in speaking in clinic. You have to be really very careful of your words. Let's suppose I normally give this example whenever you do induce or say include a new gadget in your clinic. Let's suppose an apex locator or let's say a rotary system in a root canal. So what will you sell? How will you sell that to your patient? You will say, isse root canal badhiya hogi, isse root canal achhi hogi. What you said was this. What you didn't say and may be presumed by the patient, iska matlab isse pehle ghatiya karte the. So that is the thing you have to really be very cautious of. Some things are not said, but India is a land of suppositions. People suppose and presume so many things what even are not said by the sayer. So you have to be very cautious. We have 2 ears and 1 mouth for a reason. We need to listen more and speak less. That is the bottom line. Then the ultimate aim is to basically create a patient experience or to improve the patient experience, which we all are very fond of doing. So always I say that in the beginner's mind, there are many possibility. In the expert's mind, there are few. Always be very sure of your work, very sure of your diagnosis, very sure of your opinion, very sure of your consultation. And make sure that it is a verifiable consultation, verifiable on any platform. It may be verifiable on Google, may be verifiable by any other dentist. You should not stoop to any wrong levels, even if it is the end of the month, you haven't had a good month, and your EMI is looming at the start of the next month. And maybe you can, it can set you a light on a wrong path. So that is the thing you have to actually understand. So marketing, we always say one of the shortest definition, meeting your needs profitably. This is a 3-word definition for marketing. So it does not need to be always external. The internal marketing plays a bigger role. I always give the example of the stars of the Bollywood. Of course, with the lockdown and the OTT platform shining up more than Bollywood right now, again, discounting these COVID times, what Aamir Khan, Salman Khan, Shah Rukh Khan, Akshay Kumar, Hrithik Roshan, Ajay Devgan, or whatever these A-listers, as we call them in Bollywood, can do. They can just pull the or entice the crowd or the audience for the first 3 days, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Of course, courtesy of the social media's picture buri ho to Saturday bhi pad jati hai. But let's go back to old times. At least the audience is enjoying or wants to enjoy on the first 3 days, even if the reviews are decently okay. So that is where their role is. They have to actually pull in the crowd. The same way external marketing works for us. They actually pull in the crowd or pull in the patients till our doorstep. Once the patient crosses your door and is inside your clinic, external marketing ceases to act. Then we go to the Daniel Kahneman theory. The atmosphere tends to, say, absorb or sink in into the patient. Your external marketing has no role further. At that point, your internal marketing takes over. As I say, aise bhi aur waise bhi, treatment wise. Aapne unko kaise treat kiya aur waise kaise treat kiya. Most of the patients will actually feel that you don't have actually listened to their complaint properly. And this is the most common complaint, not with dentists, but with doctors as well. People complain, doctor ne hamari baat dhang se suni hi nahi. They didn't listen to it. So that is the example I always give. If the patient is in throbbing pain and the pain is relieved by cold water, you know the damn what it is. But you don't need to be so, overconfident in front of the patient. Remember, there might be certain symptoms which the patient might be telling you. And that is actually the first consultation or the first talk with the patient. It sets the tone actually. The patient will convey many things into that. And that is the time you have to actually listen and pay patient ear to the patient or lend a patient ear to the patient. That is the time you will actually realize the patient's needs and wants actually. And these needs and wants are very critical in judging the future outcome or the longevity of the patient in your OPD. I still have patients who came to me in March or Feb 2000. They live very close by in Defense Colony only. They are my patients since the past 20 years on as well. In 20 years, I have evolved a lot. I started in a 10x7 room. Now I have a 25x15 clinic. The inside premises only and outer area separately. But then these things keep on changing. The only thing which remained constant was me and my skills. Obviously, they kept on evolving as well. But the first thing I have been always fond of is the diagnosis and the treatment plan. I used to believe at one time that there are many scenarios where no one can beat me in that. Yes, with time you lessen your skills in some matter. But again, that has been the biggest pickup point of my clinic. My diagnosis and treatment planning in many cases. The way I actually lay out and give the treatment plans to the patient, actually patients have really appreciated. And believe me, it is not about every small case that you have to do a lot of planning. It is about the medium or the large ticket cases, which you say. You need to really plan them. You really need to make a sequence for them. Make a plan here, sleep over it, write, make a plan, then write, then sleep over it. Your subconscious mind will give you ideas. Once you are doubly sure about the sequence and the plan and the cost and the way you want to proceed, then convey to the patient. Take 2 days, 3 days in between. Don't be in a hurry to start. The only problem is that we start these treatments. Patient keeps on asking, Doctor Saab, estimate to bata do, rate to bata. Kar lenge. That is the actual biggest mistake we do in our practice. So where we the consultation part, as I said, we have to lend a patient ear. Rather, we indulge in I, me and myself syndrome. So, which is actually a pitfall for many. Remember, what we are offering in our clinic are not the products. We are not selling dental products. We are selling services. We are selling services. I'll use that word. There is no harm in admitting that. Because dentistry is a business. And it is a noble profession as well. But at the end of the day, where there is a balance sheet involved, where there is IND or the income and expenditure involved, it is a business. And in our business, we don't sell products. We offer services. And products are consumed. Services are experienced. We have to remember this. We are offering services and the patients will absorb that as well. So create an environment of a 4D or a 5D or a 3D or whatever services you're offering. And you'll be delighted to see those conversions happening every now and then. Many of you might be having an 8 out of 10 conversion rate, but many of you might be having even a 3 out of 10. I'm not going to go into the numbers, but what I mean to say is that some of you might be above the average rate. Some of you may be below the worst possible rate. But then the credit for those things lies with you only. Average doesn't mean that you can't beat the average. You obviously can be on the higher side as well. But if you are on the lower side, you really have to look upon yourself that the fault lies at your end. The sooner you accept it, the sooner you will actually grow in practice via patient satisfaction. So another tip. When you have to compete with yourself. Don't compete where you might be having all, average or mediocre dentists in your area. You might be doing better than all of them. ऑलवेज से अंधों में काना राजा बनने का कोई शौक नहीं होना चाहिए. कम्पीट विद योर सेल्फ ऑफ द लास्ट ईयर. सो वॉट एवर यू एक्चुअली वॉन्ट टू कंपेयर, यू हैव टू कंपेयर. देन वर्क विद पेशेंट शेड्यूल, डू एन अपॉइंटमेंट बेसिस वर्क एंड स्टिक टू योर शेड्यूल. येस देयर मे बी ओकेजनल से मिसहैप्स इन अपॉइंटमेंट इफ आई कॉल मे दैट वे, बट मेक श्योर दैट इफ यू कैन से विजुलाइज दैट. Let's suppose your next patient is due in half an hour, and the patient you are doing, you already got an idea that he is gonna take not 15 but maybe 16 minutes more. So what you can do? Yes, in metros it is not possible, but in cities like mine it is possible. Inform the patient even before starting from home. He or she will not mind that. But once he starts home or he comes to the clinic, sorry, I too busy, I too time lagega. He'll feel cheated in a way. And if this happens, yes, occasional, once or twice, nobody minds. But if this starts happening regularly, then it creates a problem. Then it creates a real problem. So then create an excellent follow-up system for free. Your brand ambassador or your star patients. Every clinic will have such kind of patients who will actually vouch for your, say, consultation, who will blindly trust you with your whatever you offer them. So make such patients as your selling points, I always say. So I'm getting queries. Don't worry, I'll be taking up all of them in the end. So then people ask me, does office decor really matter? In a way, yes, it does matter. Why do I say so? Because it should not be unnecessarily flashy, but it shouldn't be decently good. पर्दे कहीं से गंदे ना हो, सोफा कहीं से फटा ना हो, कॉर्नर्स में डस्ट ना हो. आई ऑलवेज एडवाइस टू मेल कलीग्स, अपनी वाइफ को किसी दिन क्लिनिक ले जाइए एंड टेल देम टू हैव अ लुक एट ऑल द कॉर्नर्स. वो कोनों में डस्ट बहुत जल्दी ढूंढती हैं. सो फॉर द फीमेल्स, दे आर ऑलरेडी अडेप्टेड, इट इज अ कॉम्प्लीमेंट टू देम. सो वी एक्चुअली मेल समटाइम इग्नोर दिस, बट देन लुक एट और एंटर इन टू योर क्लिनिक समडे लाइक अ पेशेंट. And try to look into the corners, try to look at the overall look unbiasedly. Don't just overlook certain things. It may not be flashy, but it should be decently good. So that is what I believe. Then a brilliant tip I can give you is calling back. Always keep a follow-up of your patient. It hardly costs in India. Call rates are almost the cheapest in India. And courtesy Joe, they are almost at nil cost only. So we actually need to inculcate that system. We still live in that false mentality, especially in the smaller cities. Hum doctor hain, hum kyun call kare? Patient ko zarurat hogi to wo call kar lega. That is actually a wrong approach to have. So again, varied approach, different cities, different people. But that is the way I have been doing it, and I am advising what I am doing. So then I always believe that the amount of waiting time plays a big role. The amount of time the patient is going to spend in your clinic, the patient is going to absorb the atmosphere and look out for the negatives more. Human mind always looks for negativities more. It is an inbuilt phenomenon. There are very, very, very rare, I used it thrice, very, very, very rare people who will look only at the positive side of an atmosphere. Not an individual I'm talking, just about the atmosphere. Wo dekho wahan pe kitni dust hai, wo dekho wahan pe kuch phata hua hai. These kind of things. The more time you let the patient, the more negativity will creep in. And yes, it says a lot about your tongue as well. What value do you have? You give an appointment for a certain time. Yes, occasional 5 to 10 minutes is adjustable or understandable by the patient. But if you actually say go beyond that, it is not at all acceptable for anyone. So we really need to understand that. So the only thing is that appointment system should be, I always believe, maybe if it is your receptionist giving the time, but you should be actually adept in knowing it, what amount of procedure, what amount of time a procedure is going to take. Then keep a buffer zone of 15 to 20 minutes in that. If not, you can utilize it for your tea time or preparing your environment for the next. Again, thanks to COVID times, we are actually having about 30 minutes of gap. But discounting COVID times, you should be actually knowing of your abilities. Know thyself. Know yourself. Knowing yourself is a bigger art than knowing others. That I always say, you can know people fast than knowing yourself. But believe me, practice management begins with, the first step is always with knowing yourself. whenever I do a full-fledged practice management workshop of 3 days, yes, 3 days, then it starts with analysis, Briggs and Myers analysis, and many other also. It actually tells you which kind of personality you are. There are 16 types of personalities. Which kind of personality are you? And what you fall in, and accordingly you have to use your strengths, weaknesses and opportunities. Again, a part of the SWOT analysis, which I did in my paid group this lockdown. I think 10 to 12 people finished up this task with me. So then all these tips, along with listen carefully, be responsive, understand the needs and expectation of your patients, work on your brand image, encourage patient feedback, as Rajat and Dr. Praneet were discussing at the start, then measure and improve. Obviously, these are all hallmarks of improving patient satisfaction. There is no one formula that will work. It is always a combination of formula. The percentage may vary from clinic to clinic, but yes, spending time with the patient always matters, always makes a lot of difference. The more the patient knows you, the more you know the patient, the more the patient gets closer to you in terms of his understanding of your treatment outcomes and you actually understand about the patient expectations from your treatment as well. So that is the need we actually know, we really need to know. So bargaining is sometimes inversely proportional to patient satisfaction in private setups. We actually believe that, yes, there is a common Indian mentality that bargaining to karni karni na end mein, even if you have given the treatment plan. But what is the most common reason that people indulge in bargaining in clinics with doctors, which shouldn't happen? Healthcare is not a negotiable instrument. It ought to be a fixed thing. But then this thing actually, it is inversely proportional to patient satisfaction. The same David Maslow formula I gave you, S is equal to P minus E. They walked in with the E, but what do you say? They created a perception, oh, yaar, unchi dukaan, fika pakwaan wala experience hua, itna hai nahi. Itne paise deserve nahi karta hai. The only thing is, if somebody is paying you 10 rupees, he expects a 10 rupee, 10.50 or 11 rupee payback, just as an example. But even if he gets a 9.75, he'll feel cheated. Yaar, utne ka kaam kiya nahi jitne inhone paise le liye. That is the thing we actually need to understand. And it is not only the treatment that counts. It is your internal marketing which counts in this regard as well. So what is the biggest reason for bargaining, apart from the Indian mentality, of course? The biggest reason is how well the patient was treated. Aise bhi aur waise bhi, the same words. How content a patient is with the treatment received, and how much value they received in the cost they paid for. The same example I gave you for 10 and 11 and 10 and 9.75. So this is the patients have their own. As I said, there is no indicator or indices to measure it. So it is just a proxy indicator. So that is the only way you can measure the same. Then it is more than a perception. It is a proxy indicator, as I said, but it is just more than a perception. And this perception is a reality now. And the patients have only one bottom line. How did the clinic make them feel? Doctor ne mera time jada liya, lekin injection lagaya, pain nahi hua mujhe. Mereko takleef koi nahi hui. 10 साल हो गए, टाइम बहुत लिया था, पैसे लिए थे, लेकिन ट्रीटमेंट अभी भी ठीक चल रहा है. सो दिस इज द एटमॉस्फेयर. द 3D एंड द 4D एंड द 5D इज दिस ओनली. द 3D इज द ट्रीटमेंट पार्ट, द अदर डीज यू कैन से द एक्सपीरियंसेस. वी आर क्रिएटिंग पेशेंट एक्सपीरियंसेस, एंड दैट इज द बॉटम लाइन वी हैव टू एक्चुअली लुक आउट फॉर. वी आर जस्ट विद द ह्यूज नंबर ऑफ योर ओपीडी, यू आर जस्ट डूइंग वन थिंग, वर्किंग मैकेनिकली लाइक अ रोबोट. You're not in a factory, you're not manufacturing instruments. You're dealing with lives, you're dealing with live teeth, you're dealing with emotions, you're dealing with people. So you need to understand those aspects as well. So the patients will feel valued, respected and cared for. These three words have a deep meaning. Valued, they were not made to wait for long. They were treated as they were promised. Respected, they were greeted on arrival. They were safe in a way that they didn't have to face any kind of discomfort in your waiting also, even if they had to wait for a little time. Cared for, you had all the database with you, your homework was done, you had all the parts or say the patient components ready, which you wanted to convey. Believe me, record keeping is one big, say, tool which serves as a big, say, carry home for the patient. My patients, they come from so far. Believe me, mere tak pahunchte shayad raste mein unke 30 dentists aate honge. And with the time, things have changed. People usually prefer at least a nearby dentist for a, say, a PT job. They might be getting again the high ticket work done from you, the one you trust, but they might be actually interested in doing that. But they say me, main aapke paas do reason se aati hu ya aata hu, aap mere ko wait nahi karate, aapke paas mera sara kachcha chitta hai. Very small indicators, you will say waiting time or record keeping, how can they be say a say factor in patient satisfaction or patient say retention factor? This is, it is there actually. We have to really remember that these are the factors. Again, these are not the only components. These are, say, part of the whole package you are offering to the patient along with your treatment, your diagnosis, your treatment planning. 80% would still be your treatment planning, diagnosis and treatment. Nobody can skip that. But the remaining 20% is the one I'm with you today. If somebody says ki aap 80% practice management bhej doge, 20% skills, I'm sorry to say he's lying. It is the reverse. 80% still would be skills. What I teach all over India or what I'm teaching to all of you or what I teach to colleagues is the 20% part. The soft skills you may call it or your otherwise management as you may call it in terms of that. So that is the thing. Nothing can replace your raw skills which you have. They are irreplaceable. So as I said, if the practice makes them feel valued, respected and care, they will receive that there is good dental care. Even if the, say, effects have been more than, say, less than expected. So I hope you are not getting sleepy. The baby is changed today. It was a different baby, Dr. Harshada, yesterday. So we, what are the various patient satisfaction components? Because it is actually a composite or say mismatch. I wouldn't say the mismatch, but say composite of many, many factors in all. So I believe there are five components in all in patient satisfaction. Clearly and quickly comprehend what patients need and what you are able to impart to him. Patient ki need pata kahan se lagegi? When the patient will speak to you. Or if I put it in a blunt way, if you will allow him to speak. We don't do that. Acha acha pain ho raha koi nahi baitho baitho main samajh gaya koi baat nahi main dekh leta. Let the patient speak first. That is actually a wrong approach to have when we don't let the patient finish only. And paraphrasing, rephrasing or say summarizing is a brilliant part of what the patient has conveyed to you. And it is a way that yes, the doctor understood my problem completely. But even if you didn't do it, the patient has the chance to correct it. Sometimes it might be our faulty perception. But then when you talk to the patient, the contact has to be eye level. There should be no distractions. There should be no, looking at your mobile, looking at your assistant, moving your head or showing yourself as disinterested in the conversation. Believe me, that really puts off some patients. That the doctor is not even interested only to listen to. Treatment kya karega, problem nahi sunne ko tayar. So this is again a part of the perception the patient is building up. Remember that S is equal to P minus E. That P is building up slowly and slowly. The patient starts walking in. The patient is sitting in the waiting. How he was, how much time he waited, how he was greeted, how he was talked, how much time he had to wait for his appointment. Then he came in and what conversation did take place between you, your body language. These are all building up the perception, the 20% perception of the patient. And believe me, this 20% happens earlier than the remaining 80%, the skill part. The skill might come later on. So that is the thing you have to realize. Then gauging the patient expectation and managing them. You judge it, you gauge it actually, what the patient wants and you whether you are able to imbibe or not. At this point, I always say, I mentioned this in medical legal sessions as well. Never ever go beyond your skill set. Never ever attempt a treatment which is beyond your, say, ambit of your skills. Do not do that. it might be very lucrative sometimes. As I said, your EMI might be looming at the end of the month, but it is not always a good option. Then success is getting what you want. Happiness is wanting what you get. A very common proverb. The only problem is that we overpromise and underdeliver, whereas we should actually do the reverse. Underpromise and overdeliver. That is the way. You have to cross the bridge and perform beyond them. So remember, and whenever the patient is angry, whenever the patient is, say, having frustration, it usually is in the form of unmet expectations. Again, that formula P minus E will come into play at every step. Remember, it is the perception that counts, and that starts from the first 20 and not the 80. So how the patient actually felt, there can be many ways. What the patient did not experience, if the waiting period was long, if the doctor really listened, or the waiting room was not clean. These are very small examples I can give you that the patients indulge in before actually deciding. Then you have to be updated in procedures. You can't be doing. Look, for example, the COVID times. Rajat was giving an example at the start wonderfully. Unless you actually convey to the patient that you are offering something safety-wise in today's time, or otherwise updated things in today's times, you are not creating a differentiator for yourself. And unless you are not creating a differentiator, you will not be separated from the crowd. Remember that. There was a time we say, jack of all, master of none. Today it is the time of master of few. Pick your subjects, one or two or three. I fondly give the example of Dr. Rajiv Verma. He mentions many times, I have done, say, 7 to 8 implant courses, spent more than 20 lakhs in the late 90s and early 2000s, but never ever put an implant into his practice. So you actually need to understand that part. So and that is what he picked up. His niche has been crown and bridge work, veneers, and very few people can beat him at that in India. And he picked that up, and he's doing that one thing only. Even after, say, actively retiring from practice after, say, angina in 2007, he is still continuing his batches. More than 275 batches of crown and bridge and veneers in India. And that is the longest running workshop. Just an example, you cannot succeed enough. All of us can't be genius all the time. Yes, there are many geniuses among us. Somebody's audio is there at the end, I guess. So we all need to understand that whatever our strengths are, we need to harness that, overcome our weaknesses, identifying and using the best possible opportunities, and negating or diminishing the threats, whatever best we can, in the sense of SWOT. Again, that starts from knowing yourself. Unless you do your SWOT, unless you know your strengths, you can't actually do it. You need to do an aptitude test as well. So you really need to be very, say, considerate about those things. So coming to the last part of this, the ASAP funda. What is it actually? Again, a European lecturer, professor or counselor, Margaret Sumption, she's given the ASAP funda, which I believe very strongly in. I've written a lot on it as well myself. What is this ASAP? This A stands for acknowledge. People say the patients have given these studies that there is no greater insult than to be ignored. Patient has walked in and nobody is there to greet the patient or say, tell the patient that yes, good morning, good evening, you're welcome to the clinic. The procedure is taking slightly longer than expected. You will be, the doctor will be seeing you in the next 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, whatever the time is going to take. In the meantime, would you like to have any tea or coffee? This is the way you can actually start. But even if you're not offering any tea or coffee, at least greeting the patient or acknowledging the presence, that is the key. If you don't acknowledge the patient's presence, the patient say that we actually didn't exist for the doctor. Then support, the set a no-ignore rule in your clinic. If the patient has been sitting for more than 15 minutes, as I said, and nobody has actively engaged with them, you or your staff, then you'll be assured that you'll get definitely a 1-star in service or a 2-star in service in your ratings. Then delays do happen. Medicine and dentistry is not an exact science. Even if you know yourself, know your abilities, there might be some times when you will not be perfectly ending the procedure on time. Yes, these things come with experience. But as in norm, when you know that the procedure is going to take long and you have not been able to even inform the patient, as I said, inform the patient before even starting from home. Maybe possible in smaller cities like me comparatively. May not be possible in cities like Mumbai. But the way you can deal with the situation is you can actually take the blame yourself. The problem in India is that people hardly like to accept their mistake. And believe me, the day you start accepting your mistake happily, bina kaddu jaisa face banaye, believe me, you will actually start growing in life. Because unless you know that it is your mistake, you can't improve that. Unless you surrender to your mistake, you can't improve that. And then be prepared to act. When you have committed a mistake in this regard that you have not been able to take the patient on time or see the patient on time or treat him on time, make sure that you do such a thing that you go out of the way to attend to that patient. Next day, whatever option patient chooses, it might not be falling under your regular curriculum, regular schedule, but then this is the way you have to say, be ready for your folly. This is be ready to act for your folly or your mistake. Do not take it otherwise that the mistake is so bad that actually it was wrong side. It is just a thing which happens with everyone, and we are humans. We are bound to create mistakes. So just summarizing this, acknowledge and or even if the eye contact, engage your patient. Support through kind words, gestures or interaction. Accept what the patient reports as truth. Ki aapne mere ko bola tha, itne baje dekhoge, you didn't see me at this time. Yes, we are sorry, ma'am. We could not. Unfortunately, this thing happened and we couldn't inform you. Yes, accept it. Then prepare to act with a kind gesture. In whatever way you can do it. This is the only way even companies do it. Multinational people do it. Why not us? This is the step ladder to success. So why patient satisfaction should score as a top-notch priority for dentists, not for dentists, but for all healthcare personnel? Because it gives you good publicity, while a worldwide razzmatazz, as we call it. Yes, the money gains are obviously there. It is a big factor in patient retention. And then it creates room for more referrals as well. Then it gives that extra zing or the extra, G in the zing, I always say that. Then of course, when you're happy, you treat well and the treatment results are always superior as well. So again, the study by Harvard University only, if you satisfy one patient, it reaches 4 new patients. If you disappoint one, it reaches 10 potential patients. That is the thing you have to always remember. So patient satisfaction is always there once you value your tongue. You stay committed to what you had committed to the patient. And word of mouth still may be an old fashioned thing, but it is still one of the growing things one of the biggest words of referral. But yes, in today's social media, it is not the only thing, but it still holds good ground even in today's time, even in this social media savvy world. Again, the only thing is if I have to share in one line, people like to share their experiences. This is the way they engage in talk. And if they have good experiences with you, they'll definitely share with their friends, family, colleagues, their whatever circle they are doing, social circle, they're doing it. Why do I say that? Because a satisfied patient is always a great practice builder. And it is indeed one of the best strategies overall. So, listening and learning, freedom to speak up, all those things make a part of your patient experience. So make sure that you have all the ammunition in your armory into there. So create excellent patient experiences in your clinic. This is a flow chart. Of course, not all things need to be taken care of. Improve systems, processes, products and training, higher quality, efficiency and accuracy, lower operating costs, again in your hand. Definitely lower price to the customers is not intended in our part. I always believe if you are offering good services, you should charge for it rather. You should charge for it well. Then realize high customer levels, satisfaction levels, retain customers, and thereby this is the most commonly used customer experience model all over. Yes, you can modify it according to your clinic needs and go about the task of creating happy patient experiences in your clinic. So I hope I haven't been preachy enough today as well. So just before I say wind up or say stop my share for questions. So upcoming in paid group, again, it is a mini day of education for me. My late dad's birthday is on 12th August. So the first session, the basics on finance at 8 a.m. for paid group. Then at 12, I'm in talks with the group where I'll be taking up a webinar on wealth creation. Then again at 4 for the free group, the session will be there on 12th August only. So how to check the financial status of your bank. And then at 8 p.m., I have a rich dentist, poor dentist financial wisdom strategy with Endo Haveli that day only. So at 8, 12, 4 and 8, every 4 hours, I'll be having a webinar on 12th of August. It is my official leave from my clinic on that day, since it is a day that belongs to my dad, and all the sessions will be on finance. So on different platforms, 2 online and 2 on WhatsApp groups, air only. So thank you so much. Again, my request to you, there are so many videos uploaded by me. It is a channel for dentist colleagues only, not for patients. So whatever you can say, if you want, you can subscribe to the channel. You will be getting notified of these. So please do send me your valuable feedback in the WhatsApp group. So yes, I'll really appreciate. If you didn't like anything, if you liked anything, whatever, bookers and brickbats, both would be welcome in equal measure by all of you. Thank you once again. And I stop my share so that I can take up the queries first from the chat box. And then I'll be unmuting you for all the queries, whatever you want to ask. So you will be free to ask anything after that. So just a minute, just check. Okay. Dr. Sabyasachi says, sir, any phone call after treatment to the patient, how can that be perceived by them? So how can that be perceived by them? The only thing is, if I may say so, if you are indulging in telephonic consultation, if you are say wanting that, so I don't do any telephonic consultations, at least in the terms of monetary business, if I can say that, I don't do it that way. But even then, the treatment planning part also is not done on phone. I just use it for my giving appointments, and whatever lengthy discussions are to be there, they happen inside the closed room of my chamber only, and they don't happen on telephone. So Dr. Mittal, if we find more than one problematic area at first appointment, shall it be explained at the same appointment or not? The first thing is, listen to the patient first. That is where I say, listen to him or her, ask what the patient, or understand what the patient expectations are, what the patient's needs are, and how you will go about that task. If the patient has come with a chief problem or a throbbing pain, obviously the patient's priority will be that tooth only. Irrespective of the fact that there may be even graver problems than that in the mouth, but they might not be creating any issues. So the first priority is that. But as I said at the start, I hope you joined late, I guess. So at the end, do your treatment with the 3 E's and let the patient be pulled back to you. But yes, as a parting note, it is your duty to indulge in the alternate IND, as I say, the information and education part, informing the patient that there are problems graver than this or maybe lesser than this, which can become different versions. I always believe mathematically aap samjhaoge to patient ko jaldi samajh aayega. Just to give you an example in this regard, let's suppose you're charging around 7,000 for a root canal core buildup and a crown. Let's suppose. And you're charging 700 for a restoration, just presume. So, and the patient has 10 restorations to be done apart from the root canal he came to you for. Just explain the patient, you paid me 7,000. Now you have 10 more restorations to be done. 700 into 10, 10,000 more, 7,000 more. But if you want to pay me 70,000 for that, it is entirely your wish. Believe me, chahe patient padha likha ho, chahe anpadho. Of course, I'm not saying in that way, but mathematics India mein sabko samajh aata. People do relate to it, correlate to it very soon when you explain them mathematically. And yes, patients will appreciate it that the doctor could have earned 70,000 out of it and he is just happy to earn 7,000 out of the same job. So explain it in that way. But then all those things will come only when you have a heart-to-heart talk with the patient. You spend some time in the consultation. all the things say given by COVID-19 are not bad. It has allotted us the luxury of treating less, charging more. The one thing we had been yearning for our whole our lives, ki kaise system change kare clinic ka, kaise banau ki mere paas kam patient ho aur unse zyada paise lu, kam kaam karu, zyada paise ghar leke jaau. God gifted opportunity to all of you. Even still, if you don't want to take or grab that opportunity, then it is your good luck or bad luck, whatever I can say. So Dr. Archana says 4Ds and 5Ds. Again, the additional component of the treatment part, the service, the extra internal marketing or the internal management, as I say. So all those 4Ds and 5Ds, how the patient was treated, SAB or VSAB. So Dr. Kamir, thank you. Dr. Abha, thank you so much. Thank you so much. Dr. Omika, thank you. Dr. Ronak, thank you. Dr. Birinder, thank you. So I'm just unmuting all of you. If Dr. Sabyasachi, you can ask over here. I'm just unmuting, you can unmute yourselves. So anyone wants to ask anything, please feel free to ask anything by unmuting yourself. I'm all here till your queries are done. Dr. Sabyasachi, you can ask. I'm talking about phone call to the patient after any treatment, how well that thing is taken. Okay. You asked about the follow-up call. Yes, I always believe surgical patients do get a definitive call from me, surely. It is not that they can get scot-free from me. It is my duty rather, I'll do that. And a few times I've gone to their home as well, especially if the patients were old and if they had any associated problems, especially with bleeding or swelling part. I've gone to their home as well. So this is just a part of the care factor, considering if I can offer to them. So yes, if I know the patient's track record has been bad, then I don't indulge in that home service. But for normal patients, I have done that as well occasionally. So any more questions, I'll be more than happy.
Sir.
Ji.
I want to add to what you've just said.
Ji.
And as a response to the other colleague.
Ji.
We have a very strict protocol that before 3 o'clock, follow-up call will be done by the assistant to every patient who has come the previous day. It could be a simple consultation, a simple scaling, a restoration, or an implant, a full mouth, or whatever. Whatever be it. If the patient has visited us, we will call, but we will call only once. In case the patient is busy, second call will not be made. Now we will send them a message. So you read the message at your leisure time. We will not disturb you by calling you again and again. Now the colleague asked, how is the response from the patient when we do all these things? I don't know about others. People love it in our practice. This is again one of the USPs that has been mentioned by the patients, that you don't only treat and forget us, you follow up to call and you inquire. You're actually involved. It's not about that we have paid you money, you've taken the money and now you forget us. Even after taking the money, you're still concerned about us. And that's exactly why patients come back to us. So that's my experience in our practice.
Indeed. Yes, these are the small little things that add up to the patient experience only. The patients remember, the doctor ne mera khayal rakha. Ultimately, the medical and the dental care is all about the care factor. The more we inculcate in the patient's psyche or the mindset that, yes, my doctor is caring. My doctor is always there for me, always. And he's just a call away. People are very fond of say concealing their phone numbers. I don't do that. And believe me, 21 saal ho gaye, if somebody had to misuse, he could have made it by now. So 21 years is a long time. Yes, of course, I got the phone in 2003 only. But again, even 18 years is a long time. I have the same number since 18 years. So this is the thing we need to understand, that the patients come to us in discomfort, in problems. If we stay away from them, or we stay in a VIP or a shielded zone, we are not doing them any good, but we are not doing any good to ourselves as well. We need to understand that. Yes, any more queries, please?
All can clear? I just,
yeah.
Can I just add a little bit, please?
Please.
Just one or two tips from my experience.
Yes.
If anybody likes it, they can use it. Before entering the operatory, we always know the patient's name, the address, the area where the patient is coming from, and the religion of the patient. Supposedly, if Bhavdi sir comes to my clinic, supposedly, it makes no sense that I greet him with a good evening or a good afternoon. I will say, Sat Sri Akal. That is a better connect with him. But if I have another patient who is a Jain or someone like that, then I can greet him in a personalized way, a personalized greeting with their name. Never go and ask the patient, what is your name? I always enter, I greet them in a way that they would appreciate, or that's what I assume, with their name, Mr. or Miss so-and-so, how are you today? I am Dr. Rajat Anand. I am here to help you. Please tell me what happened. How can I help you today? And that's when we start talking.
Great. Yes, you act, what I do or what Rajat does, you don't need to blatantly copy that. Create your own system in your own clinic. We can only give you a roadmap. But the again, the passage or the path has to be drawn by you only. It is never a copy and a paste kind of a thing in actual life. What works for me in my clinic, if my same batchmate is there in the adjoining house to my clinic, opening up the clinic at the same time with the same number of years of experience, his way of treatment might be different. His way of dealing might be different. Even if we have the same skill set from the same college. So that is the thing you have to really understand. Five fingers are not same, so no two individuals can be same. The only thing is you have to understand your target audience first and then customize the things accordingly. Somebody might be treating an elite class. Somebody might be treating a mixed class. Somebody might be treating only the lower class. So no harm in that. But you really need to know actually what you are doing it.
Sir, another thing. You had the topic of bargaining. So I have a live example of today evening. Today evening, a patient just came to a parking slot and they called us and they took an appointment. Immediately, the girl came inside. My wife did the consultation. She had fallen a few days ago. So the 2-1 fractured. And she had a lot of pain now. So she wanted that to be addressed. When we took a radiograph, it was an open apex with abscess over there. So we told them that we have to do a root canal immediately. And this has to be an MTA plug. And that's a special medicine. And everything was explained. And then we told them that this will be approximately 9,500 rupees for the root canal alone. Crown will be a separate thing altogether. She has a cousin or someone in the family who's a dentist, but they practice in a different city, so she cannot go to them because of the pandemic issues. She gave a call to that person, and that person asked for whatever the information can be given. Because we have the habit of documenting everything, everything was sent to her WhatsApp, and then it was forwarded to the other person's WhatsApp. And they said that, yes, whatever the doctor is saying makes a lot of sense. But then again, the doctor seems to be very expensive. And the brother who was sitting in the parking the car, he was talking to the sister, and then he's like, okay, let me talk to the doctor. My wife blatantly said, I am sorry, I will not touch your mobile. Keep it on speaker. You also hear what I have to talk. And in the pandemic, I don't want to touch anything that belongs to you. I don't expect you to touch anything that belongs to me. And that fellow is like, sir, ma'am, what is this? Even in Bangalore, nobody charges so many. Why are you so high? My wife's simple response was, we do not negotiate or discuss charges. Charges are expressed by us. These are our charges. If there is anything else that you want to understand regarding the treatment, please ask me questions. I will be very happy to explain it to you. Simple as that. Then the brother is like, okay, no problem, that I will get it done in Bangalore. Please, that is your wish. You can get it done anywhere. We cannot force you that you have to get it done over here. We took the consent, the consultation charges and everything. We wrote everything. She went out. And in 2 minutes, precisely 2 minutes, she was back. I am ready. Please start the treatment. The message over here is, we have a saying in Punjabi, Pehla agle nu yarkao. Yarak jaye te, vadhiya nahi te, aap pe yarak jao. Which means, in simple words, scare the other person, push the other person. If the other person is not being pushed, then you take a step back. So every patient will try to push you. Headstrong. You need to be headstrong. Don't be rude. Don't be rude, but be headstrong. I'm extremely polite when I talk to the patients, but I am extremely headstrong. A no means a no. I will not discuss my triage. I will not do it. Come what may. That's it.
Bargaining is itself a full-fledged topic. Just I took the part of the satisfaction in it. Since you have mentioned one aspect, Rajat, I'll mention the other part here. People always say that patients will blatantly ask you, "Wo itne mein kar raha hai, aap itne mein kyun kar rahe ho?" At this point of time, you don't really need to badmouth your colleague. You don't really need to over-justify yourself. You just need to tell your point of view. We are using this. You should not be really bothered what actually the other person is doing. Have you actually gone inside the clinic and seen their materials or seen their way of working? When you have not, then why are you making an excuse? And the patient will say it. Aapne unke clinic mein jaake dekha wo kaise kaam karte hain? How can you say that? So this is the way sometimes patients will use it. So don't be oversmart. The only one line thing should be in your mind, or the approach should be, we have no argument over our, say, colleagues who charge less. We simply know what our worth is. That is the bottom line message. You keep it in your mind. You can convey it in a different manner, whatever way you can. But medical legal wise also, you don't need to badmouth your colleagues or over justify yourself. See, main to ye use kar raha hu. Again, you didn't say it. The patient presumed what I said earlier also at the start. Ki iska matlab wo ye use nahi kar rahe hain. How do you know? How do you know their set of facilities? Nobody knows. Neighboring dentist ka to kisi ko nahi pata hota uske andar kya chal raha hai. You may have assistants say hovering over there, kabhi bhi criss cross hote hain, assistant udhar se chhod ke idhar aa gaya. That happens occasionally in few areas, but even then the assistant will not have the all say inside information what is actually being done, because the human mind is trained to look at more of the negatives. As I said, we look at the negative. Wo jo positive kar raha hoga na assistant batayega na aap dekhne ki garz karenge. You will always look at the negative. Wo to aise kar raha, acha hum to isse acche baithe hain. Why do we need to justify that? You think of your own karma and your own destiny and your own good work. इतना टाइम होता है किसी के पास इतना सोचने के लिए किसी के बारे में? बिलीव मी, मेरे पास तो नहीं होता. 21 साल में मेरे पास इतना टाइम नहीं आएगा. आई कुड थिंक, मैं ऐसे चलता हूँ घोड़े की तरह, सीधा सामने, मैं देखता ही नहीं दाएं बाएं. व्हाई शुड आई लुक एट इट? मेरा अपना काम खत्म होगा तो मैं बाकी की तरफ देखूंगा ना. आई एम ऑलवेज से फॉलिंग शॉर्ट ऑफ माई टारगेट्स ऑलवेज. सो व्हाई शुड आई बी बॉदर्ड अबाउट से कम्पीटिंग विद अदर्स? आई हैव टू कम्पीट फर्स्ट विद माई सेल्फ, एंड दैट इज द बॉटम लाइन एम एवरी टाइम आई गिव इट. मैं लास्ट ईयर जुलाई अगस्त 2019 में क्या कर रहा था, क्या अचीव किया था? आई नीड टू गो अ स्टेप फर्दर. आई नीड टू इम्प्रूव माई सेल्फ. आई नीड टू इम्प्रूव माई स्किल्स. आई नीड टू इम्प्रूव माई बिहेवियर. आई नीड टू ओवरकम माई शॉर्ट कमिंग. दिस इज द वे आई एक्चुअली डू गो ऑन डूइंग इट. एंड बिलीव मी, इंट्रोस्पेक्शन इज द बेस्ट वे टू डू इट. द मोर यू इंट्रोस्पेक्ट मोर योर सेल्फ, द मोर यू विल कम आउट से ब्राइटर, इवन इन फ्रंट ऑफ द सन एज वेल, आई विल से. So any more queries, more than welcome. Or
the problem which has been discussed by Dr. Rajat, another problem has cropped up in this, that every time somebody has a relative who's a dentist, they have to make you talk to that person, and which you really don't know how to handle that.
Yes, indeed, ma'am. This is a pitfall. But then I always say that whatever system you have, you should be very, say, open in conveying it to your even relatives, common friends, or whatever group of patients you are treating. You convey to your colleagues that whatever the way you work, let's suppose I have a policy of 20% for a discount for relatives. Convey it there and then. This is the actual we charge. And
it's not just about money. It's yes. About the diagnosis also. At times they'll say something yes. else, and you
yes,
have
that. But then that is why I said at the start as well, I think you joined in slightly late, in that I said, this is your skill which cannot be replaced. This is the 80% of your total 100%. And this is the thing you should stand for, your diagnosis, your treatment planning. You should be very proud of it, and you should have a skill which nobody can beat you at. This should be your strongest selling point. And the opinion which you give to your patient, your consultation, should be verifiable on any platform. So that is the way I actually look at it.
Totally.
Yeah. I have a question. So like
yes.
last week I had a patient who came down and said that let's get my wisdom tooth removed. And once we have removed that, he came back the next day saying that my cousin, who is a dentist, is saying that the tooth is still left behind. Like a root part is still left behind. And I did not know how to... let me be very frank, I was very angry. It was kaddu ka face ho gaya tha. So, how would you handle this?
Ma'am, I always say, jab bhi koi aise kehta na, tell the person to give it in written. One line only. Even if I am angry, I will not show it. I say, tell the person to give it to me written. If I am sure that what I have done, if I am 100% sure of what I have done, I normally don't leave root stumps in between. I am sure that I have done it in full. But if the alveolar bone is being perceived as a root stump or is being wrongly conveyed, or the marginal buccal bone, what I am saying, is being conveyed as the root stump to the patient, then just say, tell the doctor to give it to me in written. And I'll take an action over it.
This was not even the X-ray was shared with the patient. The patient told his brother, and just looking at he wanted the tooth. So we had to give him the tooth. And once the tooth was given, he said, no, this is a broken tooth. And he wanted me to talk to his dentist brother.
If you were sure, why you would be afraid then? You shouldn't
be
afraid.
I was afraid. I was angry.
Angry. Both the things. You shouldn't be afraid or of sharing the tooth. Or being angry over a thing which even you didn't commit also. So there will be all kinds of people you'll be meeting every day. People will never be very kind always. So you have to remember, sab Bhagwan ke banaye bande hain. They all deal in a different manner. So this is the way you deal with the situation. Apna BP badha ke aapko kya milega? If you are sure, sir, give it to me. Yep.
Sir, if I may add.
Sure, sure.
What we do is, we take a lot of photographs for the simplest of procedure other than scaling. We have a minimum 15 to 20 set of photographs for every procedure, and that's the bare minimum, and at least one video of the procedure. Now, supposedly, coming back to this case, if I was supposed to remove a wisdom tooth, or my oral surgeon, I don't do it, I call an oral surgeon. My oral surgeon, we will first have a preoperative radiograph, then we will have photographs of the tooth being removed, just like the PG days. My oral surgeon, I have informed him, he has to wash the tooth, keep it on the gauze. I will come, I will click a photograph. Then the photograph of the socket will be taken. A video of the socket will be made, because that is, it's dynamic, it's not static. Video is dynamic. So information can be missing in a static, but not in a dynamic video. And then all this is shared with the patient as well. Now, in case the patient or whoever the relative or whoever is alleging that I have left it back, I will tell them, please prove it, and I will take the onus of it. I have no problems with it. We are all humans. I am a human being. I'm not God. If I don't commit mistakes, I'll become God. I do commit mistakes probably every day, and that's me. That's okay. I will take the onus. And in case I have committed a mistake, I will face the consequences, and I will see to it that you are treated to the best of my knowledge at my expense, because it is my responsibility. The treatment and the patient is my responsibility. Sure. Coming back to the previous colleague's answer, if I have had many a patients who have some or the other relative who's a dentist, most of the times, and I'm extremely sorry, but this is my way, I always make a point that I will talk to whoever the dentist in your family or in your distant relative is, and I will explain it to them in simple terms only once. I will share radiographs and whatever the information that I have. After which, if you are only trying to show that you are bigger, better, more senior, more experienced than me, you're trying to bully me, then I have my ways. I can talk, and I can talk science. I can use words that you have never heard of, because I will go back to the college days, and then I will put you down, prove my dominance over you. Then I will show the card that I was head for a dental chain and you are not. I will show the card that I'm a prosthodontist and I'm a senior and I'm an implantologist and everything. Only if they start bullying me, then I bully them, I push them down, and then I tell them, it's completely up to the patient to take your advice, get the treatment by you or anywhere else. This is how I have planned it. Until and unless you want to challenge it, let's not have any further discussions. It makes no sense. Let's not waste each other's time. And that's it. Blessings by the God, I've never failed. As of now. Till now.
Definitely. Dr. Kamid also mentioned, can't we just take our post-operative IOP in this situation and explain? That is what I said. You actually have to convey to the patient whatever the patient is alleging on you. Just give it to me in written. Because people will make oral statements at free will. The tongue is free to speak. The right of speech of freedom should be barred. I strongly say, or it should be at least limited in some regard. Because in India, we have lots of problems because of the speech of freedom, I believe. that right to freedom. But yes, people will always say one thing that oral mein bolna sana, likhne mein aayenge, they'll know that they are actually lying. So yes, sometimes the situation is such that the patient will not allow you to take an x-ray also. But I only say one thing, if you are sure of what you have done, you shouldn't be afraid of everyone and you shouldn't unnecessarily increase the profit of hypertensive companies. Oh, sorry, the company selling hypertensive tablets. I'm not a big fan of them. I want to stay from them as far as I can. Yes, I do have my anger issues since childhood, but I have controlled them a lot by at least 80-90%. I'm just 10 to 20% AYM, angry young man left. So even the young man left is lesser in me. So the angry part automatically has to go away. So in that sense, but yes, you shouldn't fret and say frown over such things. People will keep on speaking. Remember, speech is free in India. And anything that is free in India will be abused always. So don't worry about what people say. If people start talking behind your back, it means that you're growing. Don't worry. At times, patients become hypertensive unnecessarily. How should we react? The only thing is that you should lower down your tone. Let the patient vent out first. There is a separate when I deal with the communication part, how to deal with the angry patient and different type of patients. I have that slide. Maybe sometime later I'll be taking up that presentation as well on communication. But let the patient vent out. Once the patient is fully done, we actually then can put in our word in a softer tone after offering them a glass of water. Making a sign to your assistant to fetch a glass of water. Let the patient vent out. And once that patient is done with his say outburst, I will say, then give him, offer him a glass of water and then speak your, whatever you have to speak in a soft tone. Because once the patient is fueled with anger and you also start speaking in the same tune, believe me, it adds fuel to the fire. It is not going to say tone down the tempers in any way. You can understand that. It only creates bad blood between the two of you. And if by chance any patients are sitting in the waiting, it will further create a bad reputation or a whole ruckus kind of environment in there. So better always try to avoid the situation in a soft manner rather than, say, behaving like an AYM or an angry young man. That is the carry home message, I will say. Because two shouting people can never listen to each other. That is the thing you have to understand. Only one can be heard at a time. So, remember that. So anything more? Or I say, I'm stuck between your dinner and the session. So I want, if anything is there, you can ask me in the group as well. Please do put in your feedback in the group as well. Yes, you have put in here, but surely do so in the group. So thank you so much for being here. 12th August, we meet next. I have two sessions on FB, hopefully, and one for the paid group at 4 p.m. I hope that those will be worth to you on that day. So thank you so much. Have a good night. Take care. Bye-bye. Till we meet again.
Thank you, sir.